sir. Welcome back to our channel, AsappJobs Lab. And this is yet another episode of interview with selected candidate. And today we are at OLA office, OLA. And today we are taking an interview of Vishal. So Vishal basically working in OLA, and he got selected OLA as an iOS developer, right? Recently. So today, Vishal is going to share his interview experience with us. What exactly happened? How did he apply? You know, OLA and stuff and all, right? So yeah, Vishal, first of all, most welcome to our channel. And our user wanted to know exactly about you first. So you can give a brief intro about yourself, like about starting from the college and experience. Yeah.
Sure. So I am graduated from Pune University. Mm-hmm. 2012. Mm-hmm. After that, actually, I wanted to do the masters. Mm-hmm. So even I applied for GATE.
Okay.
I scored good numbers, but still I didn't get IIT. So I dropped that plan totally. And then I joined Global Logic in 2013.
Okay.
As a fresher. Uh-huh. And then they put me in iOS team.
They are in the Global Logic.
Yeah, they are in the Global Logic as a fresher.
Okay.
Okay. And then I started learning about the iOS. I got good matrix as well.
Okay,
and after 6 months of training and probation period, I was put on where as a project.
Mm-hmm.
So there I got a good exposure about the processes and tech stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I worked there for around 2.5 years.
2.5 years.
Yeah.
Okay.
So there I got a chance to work with the Verizon and Reliance.
Oh, nice.
Okay. And on the basis of Verizon experience, mm-hmm. I got selected in the Shopper Stop.
Okay.
The e-commerce application.
Mm-hmm.
So actually we developed Shopper Stop e-commerce application from scratch.
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah. And even
and again the same in iOS platform.
Yes, right? Exactly. Yeah.
Okay.
And even there also I spent around 2.5 years.
Nice. Okay.
And I thought that there is not much work and not much to learn.
But you didn't find challenging
work there. So I thought it's a time to switch.
So that's how you landed to OLA.
Yeah, so actually at that time I started applying via LinkedIn.
Uh-huh.
So I prefer LinkedIn as the most reliable channel to apply
for job.
The first round was a telephonic call.
Yeah, so Vishal, sorry to interrupt that. So before telephonic round, so can you just share, you know, how what was your initial discussion with the HR over here? Mm-hmm. So you had applied through LinkedIn.
Yeah.
So did HR of OLA, you know, she had called you, or he had called you, or some third party, you know, they might have, you know, scheduled an interview. So how was that?
No, so actually I got called directly from OLA.
OLA HR.
Yeah, OLA HR. Mm-hmm. And asked about my availability. I mm-hmm. said I'm free.
Okay.
And I think in couple of hours they scheduled the telephonic interview.
Tell me more about your first round then.
Yeah. He asked me about the iOS fundamentals. And about my projects. Mm-hmm. And then he started about data structures and algorithms.
So basically, projects, obviously, you know, whatever you had mentioned in your resume, mm-hmm. from there they have picked your project, is it?
Yeah. Along with that, I was interviewed on data structures.
So do you remember any questions?
So those questions were basically based on graphs.
Okay.
Depth first search and breadth first search.
Okay.
So we call it as a DFS and BFS.
Yes, yeah.
So those are basically the graph questions and again indexing questions.
Indexing questions.
Yeah.
Like what?
If you want to create dictionary kind of thing.
Okay.
Because it was a telephonic round, so
obviously they were not expecting you to write a code.
Write a code, yeah.
They wanted to understand your how you approach any problem, right?
Exactly. So I was asked one question about some scenario,
mm-hmm.
and he was expecting that I should answer it like it is based on a DFS. Or it's based on a graph theory.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what actually he was expecting.
Okay.
And actually, I gave that answer.
So you gave exactly. You met their expectations.
Exactly. And the evening itself, I got a call that okay, they wanted me to come here in
For the face-to-face
round. Face-to-face
round. So how long you had your first round of interview?
I think it lasts about 1.5 hours.
Okay.
That first telephonic round.
Mm-hmm.
And I think after 3-4 days, they called me for the face-to-face round. They booked everything, so they gave me flight tickets and accommodation. And they called me up one night before.
Mm-hmm.
So I came here late night, mm-hmm. and they provided all the accommodation and yeah. The next day morning, I came here,
mm-hmm.
And that I met with HR,
mm-hmm.
And they started my face-to-face.
Okay.
I think that day I had around. I think I had 5 rounds.
Okay, in that day.
Yeah.
You
three technical, mm-hmm. plus 2 managerial.
Okay, so let's now deep down into every interview round then. So now tell us what exactly happened in your first round of interview.
First round was again taken by the same guy.
Okay.
Who took my telephone
interview. Yeah.
And he asked me about iOS fundamentals,
mm-hmm.
and projects,
mm-hmm.
Design patterns.
Okay.
And then the second half of that round, mm-hmm. was typically on the data structures algorithms.
Okay, so are you able to recall what was those questions,
yeah,
starting
sure.
from your iOS fundamentals?
Yeah, questions? So basically in iOS fundamentals, he asked me about design patterns,
mm-hmm.
which are design patterns I have used,
mm-hmm.
And where to use those design patterns.
Okay.
And again, a few questions on the basics of iOS, like what is strong, life cycle of iOS,
mm-hmm.
and then what is singleton,
mm-hmm.
How will you create a singleton,
mm-hmm.
How many ways are there,
mm-hmm.
to create singleton classes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Which is, I think this is a pretty
standard question,
right?
Yeah.
So did he ask you like tell me the scenario where you use a singleton or something like that?
Yeah. So he asked me about that too, and again he asked me like how will you ensure,
mm-hmm.
that this particular object is singleton. I will ensure that.
Okay.
So
reference counting, I guess. No.
Not reference counting,
okay.
but the basics of that,
uh-huh.
Is again in the fundamentals of the C.
Okay.
So, mm-hmm. that's why I only told if you have the strong basics,
uh-huh.
then definitely you can answer those questions.
Okay.
Again, a couple of questions were on the arrays.
Mm-hmm.
Like mutable arrays and normal arrays.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and few questions.
So this is under data structures question.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Okay.
No. These questions were on iOS.
iOS.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
There were a couple of questions on synchronization as well.
Okay.
How will you store data in iOS app?
Mm-hmm.
And how will you keep that data? In sync with basically in sync, how will you keep the data in sync?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And after that, he started on algorithms.
Algorithms.
And he asked me about arrays,
mm-hmm.
Basic questions on linked lists,
mm-hmm.
and then a couple of questions on trees.
Okay. So,
how will you find out the diameter of a tree?
The width of the tree.
Not width, actually, it's a diameter. So basically, it's the longest possible distance between any two nodes of a tree.
Okay.
It's the longest possible distance.
So basically, you can say the leftmost tree, the distance between the leftmost leaf node, and the rightmost leaf node.
Not necessary.
Okay, yeah, not necessary, yes,
yeah.
Exactly.
It can be on the right.
Yeah, I understood that,
yeah.
Let's say keep one side, they are having a children's,
mm-hmm.
another side it is not growing up, right?
Exactly.
So on one side, you'll have so many
nodes,
yeah,
right? Correct.
So it's not necessary that they're like most.
Yeah, exactly. So those kind of questions were there.
Mm-hmm.
Again, majorly, interviewer was focusing on the array questions.
Mm-hmm.
Finding kth element from last kind of questions.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So
kth element in the sorted order, something like that. Kth element in the sorted.
Yeah, if there is a unsorted array, then
find the kth largest element, something like
kind
that.
Kind of, yeah.
Okay.
So that was a quite easy round,
mm-hmm.
in terms of DS algo.
Mm-hmm.
That round lasts around an hour.
Uh-huh.
And I think after 15 minutes or half an hour after that, second round was started.
Okay, so in the first round, I'll just summarize that. This was the first time, so you had questions related to iOS basics questions, and then you had some couple of questions from data searches.
Yeah.
Right. So what is these two fields, and apart from that, any DB database?
See, as we are not using database here.
Okay. So based on the requirement, requirement was not there, so they did ask you any questions related to database.
Yeah. There are few scenarios wherein we use database. But those databases are like local to the iOS. So like we use plist. So those questions were also asked.
Okay, so now let's start then the second round.
Yeah, so second round was purely on the DS and algo.
Okay.
Yeah, so that was the most interesting round.
I am so eager to know about it.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the question was like there are K linked list, no sorry, not linked list, K arrays.
K arrays,
unsorted arrays, K unsorted arrays. And you'll have to merge those arrays. And after that, he gave me two integers, like N1 and N2. You'll have to find a sub-range of, sub-range between those two integers, such that the numbers from that sub-range should exist in the list. So like at least one number from the subrange should exist in each list.
Each list. You had unsorted arrays,
K's
and unsorted arrays, and they have given you two numbers.
Yeah, N1 and N2.
N1 and N2.
Yeah.
And now you have to, what you have to do, you have to merge those
arrays.
Yeah. So after merging, you have to sort. No, that was not the the given condition, right? So basically you have to merge. And obviously, you have to make sure that all the numbers who's within this range, N1 and N2, in such a way that at least one number should be coming from at least a list, right? At least one number.
Yeah, at least one number.
Right?
From each array.
From each number.
Yeah.
You have to make sure that.
Yeah.
Is it possible to solve such kind of problems in the interview?
Yeah, so actually, I saw one problem on board.
I think the complex level of this question is very high.
Yeah, so that was a tough round actually, but I already told that was purely on DSLGO.
Okay, so tell me, how did you take it? Like, how long you took to solve this problem, or did you try to attempt this question or not? First thing.
So
I think I should be asking this question.
Yeah, so I attempted and I solved it.
Oh wow, congrats. not tell me how long you took to solve this problem.
Yeah, so I think I solved that question in few phases.
Okay,
so like the first phase was like to merge those arrays. And I told the complexity of that merging. So that was the first part.
So basically this is a K-way merging, right? Yeah. Merging.
And after that, he asked me to prove that the complexity will be that which I told. So we started solving that problem of finding the complexity. And so that again took it around, I think, 15-20 minutes.
But total, how much time it took?
I think total time, I took it around 1.5 hours. For one question.
Second round.
Yeah, and that round lasts around 2 hours. Because after that,
you had some kind of discussion with the interviewer, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
We took some test cases and we dry run it. So
nice. So 2 hours for the second round of interview and only one question.
Yeah, only one question.
And apart from that, anything else did we ask for?
No, I think that guy was from backend.
Okay.
Actually, he was a backend developer.
Mm-hmm.
So he didn't know about the iOS.
Okay.
Concluded that second round?
Please go
ahead.
Sorry.
So actually, we took lots of many test cases and we tried to dry run it. So and we again tried to optimize that question. Even the editor was helping me. So we were taking test cases and we used to dry run it. Actually, we tried run it and to make sure. Actually, we made sure that this is the optimal solution. We tried to again optimize it again, but then at last actually he said, okay, I'm satisfied with the solution.
Yeah, so here I wanted to add one point to the user. So if you are facing such kind of problems in the interview, so just remember this always, you are not alone. I mean, the interviewer itself, he will come forward to help you out, right?
Yeah.
He will keep on giving you some kind of hints or something like that, so that, you know, you can solve the problem at the end, okay? Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, so after that I had lunch, mm-hmm. and then third round started,
mm-hmm.
I think after an hour.
So this third round you had just because you maybe you would have qualified for first and second round.
Second
round,
yeah.
Okay.
Maybe the feedback was okay,
mm-hmm.
For the first two rounds.
Yes, exactly.
And in that round, actually, that round was taken by a guy from another team.
Mm-hmm.
And that round was again on the iOS,
mm-hmm.
plus DSL.
Okay.
So that was the third technical round.
Mm-hmm.
And in that round, that guy asked more detailed questions on iOS,
mm-hmm.
like about the Xcode configurations,
mm-hmm.
like your project configurations,
mm-hmm.
and insights of like profile management,
mm-hmm.
and like how you configure the project,
mm-hmm.
and a few questions on again design patterns.
Okay.
Ask me about Viper design pattern,
okay.
which I think they are using, they mm-hmm. might be using in their project.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't work on the Viper design pattern, so I said I don't have much idea.
Oh, yeah, got it. Okay. Yes. So this is a, again another point. If you are not pretty much confident about certain questions, you can straightforward, you can tell that.
Yes.
Right? You don't know about that. Unlike, I'm not talking about the DS things. Obviously, DS questions, if you don't know, but you have to try to attempt that question, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
But a question like iOS basics, this is like, moreover, if you don't know, you don't know, right?
Yeah.
So you can escape it, or you can tell directly to the interviewer. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. And again, as I said earlier, the round was more about the iOS deep questions,
mm-hmm.
Is it possible to declare variables in category of class?
Okay.
Kind of questions like that.
Mm-hmm.
So, and again, a few questions were there from my resume.
Okay, so resume, they picked it.
A couple of keywords they picked up,
uh-huh.
and they asked me about those questions. Then again, the DS round started.
Okay.
And he asked me about a couple of questions on linked lists.
Okay.
Like. Finding the merging point of a linked list, if there is a
merging point, like two linked lists and merging is somewhere, then you have to find out
the merge point. Yeah, and again, like if there's a loop in linked lists or not, how do you find out the merging point again? And those were easy questions.
Mm-hmm.
There was one more question, like he asked me to. Code on the random number generator. So he asked me like, you don't have any APIs, and you'll have to find out the logic. You'll have to write the logic for generating a random number.
Random number generation. Okay.
Yeah. So I started from like taking a small range.
Mm-hmm.
I executed that. So that was like I saw that. Then he asked me to take a larger range.
Yeah. So this is another. The important point I wanted to add again here. So whenever you try to solve any big complex problem or something like that, then you always take a small data set.
Yeah.
Right? Try to solve your problem with that small data set first, and once it is proved, then you can take a longer data set, right?
Correct.
So it is like mathematical indexing types. You know, first you have to prove for n equal to 1, then n equal to 2.
Yeah. So that's how I solved that question.
Mm-hmm.
And he asked me a few questions on like static libraries and frameworks,
mm-hmm.
which I didn't work on,
mm-hmm.
that time.
Okay.
So I straightforward said that, straightforwardly said that I didn't work on those stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't have much idea about it.
Okay, that's fine.
So that was okay round for me. And after that.
So this exactly. So just for the quick summary, third round you had iOS basic questions.
Yeah.
DS.
Yeah.
And that's it.
And again, some application questions.
Applications questions. Okay. Then.
So then third round ended.
Mm-hmm.
After that.
How long this round took?
That took around 1 hour.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, fourth round was a managerial round.
Okay.
Okay. So that was again that the guy asked me about my projects,
mm-hmm.
The processes that I work with,
mm-hmm. So purely based on the things which you have written in the resume, right? We picked up the question from there.
From
like,
yeah, so what, you know, mm-hmm. on the projects, basically you can ask few questions,
mm-hmm.
regarding the what process you have followed and all.
Mm-hmm.
So those kind of the questions were there,
mm-hmm.
and again he asked me about how was your so how were your rounds
so far. Okay. Mm-hmm.
So that was there, and he asked me about the third round typically.
Okay.
He asked like how was your third round. I said it was not that good, and it was okay. So he asked why. So I explained that scenario, like I need to work on
certain things.
So I couldn't answer those questions.
Yes.
So he said okay. And then so that was the fourth round.
Uh-huh.
And then fifth round was the managerial round, hiring managerial round.
Mm-hmm.
And we had a conversation on my projects,
mm-hmm.
What actually I'm expecting from this company,
mm-hmm.
and so what are my
expectations? They are asked you.
Yes.
What is your expectations from this OLA?
Exactly. So mm-hmm. what do you want?
Mm-hmm.
So we want to be a full stack developer.
Mm-hmm.
He actually explained me about kinds of full stack developers. Like
mm-hmm.
if you are in iOS,
mm-hmm.
you can learn Android also.
Mm-hmm.
So that is a kind of full stack developer.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can learn iOS, Android, and then UI like web part.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can learn.
You can go towards back end side
also.
Mm-hmm.
So like iOS and back end.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So he told me like. Will give you opportunity to learn all the stuff.
Okay.
So just any point of time, just tell me what you want to learn. And
so the fifth round was pretty much clear that you are about to shortlist.
That hint actually I got from one caller session.
Uh-huh.
So like, so when we were discussing, he told me like, Vishal, do you know, there is one interesting thing I found on in your resume.
Okay.
So I said, what? So he said, where is it?
Oh, okay.
So that was
the
first project.
Okay.
Yeah, so
for the Verizon.
Yeah,
so that you had mentioned that. Okay.
Yeah. So that was actually a very good project.
Mm-hmm.
I worked on.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe that helped me to get to enter here.
Nice.
So
you never know. If you're coming for the interview, what they will look into your resume.
Exactly.
So that's what writing a resume is very important.
Important. Yeah.
Right. So you need to know this always. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so sorry to interrupt, but how long was your fourth round of interview and the fifth round of interview?
So, both I think last around half an hour each.
Half an hour each?
Yeah.
Okay. And did they ask you anything related to behavior or, kind of question like, how you will handle if you have such kind of scenario?
Yes,
obviously.
Any
such kind of problem in your
past? Yeah,
okay.
So, they asked me about the most challenging part kind
okay.
of questions.
Uh-huh.
So, and, how did you handle it?
Okay.
So, what are things you did to to solve those problems?
Uh-huh.
So those kind of questions are also over there.
Nice. Okay. Cool. So then you have the entire interview. I think it is over for that particular day.
Yeah.
Right?
So I think around at 5 o'clock around,
mm-hmm.
HR came and asked me to leave.
Okay.
Because I think and they dropped me. On the airport also. So the next day they called me and said like okay I got selected, and then they told me like they'll release offer later.
So HR she didn't ask any question like okay why you are leaving this company, why you wanted to apply here, that standard HR question.
I think that those questions were asked in HR telephonic first discussion itself.
Okay. So it happens sometimes, even before starting your telephonic or before some of interview.
Yeah.
Before that itself, HR will ask you all these basic questions like what is your expected CTC, why you wanted to join our company, why you're leaving your company and stuff, and also these things happen with you.
Yeah.
Before telephonic interview, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Nice.
Then I left for the day, and after the day I got a confirmation that I got selected, and I think after that day is 2 days after I got an offer.
Okay.
Nice. I think in 4 to 5 days actually I joined OLA.
4 to 5 days. Obviously, no one's wanted to leave such kind of opportunity, right? Anyway, so I think you were serving a notice period, right? When
yeah, that time. Yeah.
Right? Okay. Nice. That's really nice. And apart from that, you wanted to share anything, let's say if any candidate is coming for the OLA, right? So you want to give any tips, pro tips, kind of starting from the resume, maybe resume, maybe, you know, you can refer them something like some sites like for the interview preparation, something like that, anything, whatever you.
Yeah, so I'll definitely share. Mm-hmm. So the first thing on the resume part, I think you should have like a one page resume, which is spread.
One page resume.
Yeah, so that should be pretty much clear about your projects and the highlights of your projects and which are things you worked on.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's what basically recruiters see or the managers see.
Mm-hmm.
And
so basically, if someone has to make one page resume, now obviously they cannot mention each and everything. I mean to say, they cannot elaborate the points. Like they can mention the highlights of the project, but they cannot actually explain their. You know, you might have seen that they will explain a little bit like what they have done, this stuff and all.
No, so like you can mention the highlights of that project in like 2 to 3 lines for each project. And I think you should not mention if you have like. 10 years or 8 to 10 years or 5 or 15 years of experience, then I think you should mention the first 4 to 5 projects or first to 5 companies, and the rest you can tell only the names of those companies, because you can't mention every company.
Everything.
I think the managers, because I worked on screening those resumes as well, so I know the basically managers see your last 3 to 4 years of experience on which platform and which companies on which projects you have worked on.
Okay. I also prefer one page resume, by the way.
So that was about the resume. And about the technical part, I would say please prepare the basics. If you are from the CS background, then I think you should study more on the operating systems.
So this is for which user you are saying, like let's say the guy who is having a 3 to 5 years experience, or you are saying that?
So in general, I am saying about like, you can say from 2 years to like 6, 7 or 8 years of experience.
Okay.
So I would suggest you should, if you are from the CS background, so then you must have studied about the computer science core subjects like operating systems, computer networks, and again, then algorithms, data structures, because the basics of those things help you to solve few problems.
I mean to say, this is another thing, like if you don't know the basic, you can't even start solving the problem.
Yeah, so I can give you one example, like if you want to create a kind of caching algorithm, then you must know the basics of operating systems. So that's how it helps.
So any reference, like from where a user has to go and get prepared for the interview, any reference, like any sites, any blogs?
I would say, so as far as I refer, I prefer for Git. So I think the Git material is the best things that you can refer
for the basic preparation.
Yeah, for the basic preparations, you can refer the Git material from where you can get the important parts.
Important parts. And for the interview, any so basically you didn't follow any particular site, something like that, like any blog, lead code, anything, nothing like that.
Geek for Geeks for DSL goes.
Achha, DA for DS, Geeks for Geeks. But in future, it will be AsappJobs.
And for like iOS per se, Ray Vanderlich, and there are. There is one more blog written by, I think, Matt Hardy, I guess. He's a developer of AF Networking Library.
Okay.
So, actually, he wrote very good blogs. Okay. You can refer those blogs as well.
Okay. Anyway, by the way, so all these informations you can find in the description of this video.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's nice. So I think, so this is like a pro tip for all you people. So please follow that, and moreover, what we are going to do, we are going to mention Vishal profile in the description again, LinkedIn profile. So in case, in future, right, if you want to have any kind of discussion with Vishal related to the interview in OLA, so you can contact Vishal, I guess. So I think Vishal should not have any problem with that, right? So, and maybe the reference around, you can get the difference also, right?
Yeah.
So for that also, you can contact me, sir, right? Okay, so Vishal, so thanks a lot.